Hi guys, I'm Johnny from the PE Tutor. Thanks for taking your time to watch today's mini lesson, especially from a series that we've just finished putting together for all of our Level 2 BTech sports students. So if you are studying for that Unit 1 exam or you're a teacher and you have your own student preparing for that exam, then please do subscribe to this channel and you can use all of our mini lessons uploaded here on YouTube or click on the link below. We've actually just finished putting together a free flashcard pack for all students and teachers alike to use to really help you prepare for that exam. Anyway, hope you enjoy the lesson and I'll see you again soon. So in today's mini lesson, we're gonna be looking at the Borg scale. Now the first thing that you need to be aware of when it comes to the Borg scale is that it works on something called the RPE, or the Rate of Perceived Exertion. Now what this is a performer's self-assessment or self-estimate of how hard they feel they're currently working. So a performer self-assesses or estimates how hard they're working between a scale of 6 and 20. We are to multiply the score that they give by 10. We can actually correlate it to what their heart rate might be at the time that they give their score. Okay, so 6 times 10, or 11 by 10, or 20 by 10, that gives us an estimate of what their heart rate might currently be. Now, it is only an estimate, so it's not as accurate as actually taking a heart rate, or actually taking blood pressure, or gas in and gas out. Okay, it's an estimate. So, if a performer is at complete rest, they've been sitting down or lying down for a couple of minutes, and they score 6, we times that by 10, it's likely their heart rate's going to be close to being 60 beats per minute. With the average performer being between 65 and 75 beats per minute at rest, that's a good estimate. Alternatively, if a performer gives the maximal score of 20 and they're pushing themselves to the absolute limit, they're going to be close to their maximum heart rate, which, as we should know by now, maximum heart rate is 220 minus the performer's age to arrive at that figure. So 20 multiplied by 10 gives us a probable heart rate of around 200 beats per minute, which is in keeping with their maximum heart rate estimate. So in summary, we know that RPE stands for Rate of Perceived Exertion. We know that the scores go from 6 up to 20, 6 being absolute rest, 20 being absolute maximal effort. And we also know that it's not entirely accurate because it is only an estimate from the performer's feeling. So, I hope that was useful. If you do have any questions, leave them in the comments and one of our team will get back to you. Alternatively, subscribe to the channel and you can watch all of these mini lessons in the build-up to your exam. See you again soon.